إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله. Indeed, the most truthful of speech is the book of Allah. وَخَيْرُ الْهَدِي هَدْيُ مُحَمَّدٍ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. And the best guidance is the guidance of our beloved messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. وَشَرُ الْأُمُورِ مُحْدَثَاتُهَا. And the worst of affairs are those things we newly invent into this religion of ours. وَكُلَّ مُحْدَثَةٍ بِدْعَةٍ. And everything we newly invent into this religion of ours is an innovation. وَكُلَّ بِدْعَةٍ ضَلَالَةٍ. And every innovation is misguidance and it leads astray. وَقُلَّ ضَلَالَةٍ فِي النَّارِ. Every going astray, every misguidance is in the hellfire. ثُمَّ أَمَّا بَعْدُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says in the Quran, ثُمَّ أَوْرَثْنَا الْكِتَابَ الَّذِينَ اصْطَفَيْنَا مِنْ عِبَادِنَا فَمِنْهُمْ ظَالِمٌ لِنَفْسِهِ وَمِنْهُمْ مُقْتَصِدٌ وَمِنْهُمْ سَابِقٌ بِالْخَيْرَاتِ بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْفَضْلُ الْكَبِيرُ. Allah says in the Quran what means. Then we gave the book, the Quran, for inheritance to such of our slaves whom we chose to be the followers of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then of them are some who wrong themselves. Of them are those who pick the middle course. And of them are those who, by Allah's permission, are the foremost in good deeds. The inheritance of the Quran, that is indeed a great grace. So Allah, He specified three groups for His ibad. Minhum ظَالِمٌ لِنَفْسِهِ. The first one, they are the ones who wrong themselves. They sin, they're lazy, they're negligent with their fara'id, with their prayers, with their zakat, with their charity, and the likes of this. وَمِنْهُمْ مُقْتَصِدٌ. And of them are those who follow the middle course. They stick with the middle path. All they want to do is the basics, the minimum, and nothing more. And we get this from the hadith of Abu Suhail, narrated from his father, that he heard Talha ibn Ubaidullah saying, a man from Najd came with unkempt hair, and he came to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he was speaking loudly, but his speech could not be understood. فَإِذَا هُوَ يَسْأَلْ عَنِ الْإِسْلَامِ قَالَ لَهُ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ خمس صلوات في اليوم والليلة قال هل علي غيرهن قال لا إلا أن تطوع قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وصيام شهر رمضان قال هل علي غيره قال لا إلا أن تطوع وذكر له رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الزكاة فقال هل علي غيرها قال لا إلا أن تطوع فأدبر الرجل وهو يقول لا أزيد على هذا ولا أنقص منه فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أفلح إن صدق. This man came and he asked about Islam. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم told him it's to pray five times in the day and the night. The man said, is there any more? The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, no, unless you want to do so voluntarily. Then the man came and then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم told him, and to fast the month of Ramadan. The man said, is there anything more for me to do? He said, no, unless you want to do so voluntarily. So then he told the man that you have to pay zakat, alms on your wealth. The man asked, is there any more for me to do? So the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam again said, no, unless you want to do so voluntarily. This man said, I'm going to do nothing more and nothing less than what you have told me. And he walked away. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, if this man is truthful, he will be successful. So ومنهم, from this group, we find those who are مقتصد, مقصد, يعني those who are going to just follow the middle course and the middle way. And the last group, وَمِنْهُمْ سَابِقٌ بِالْخَيْرَاتِ بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْفَضْلُ الْكَبِيرُ. And of them are those who's by Allah's permission. They are foremost in good deeds. The inheritance of the Quran, that is indeed a great grace. These are the ones who are the foremost, not just to do the minimum, not just to do the basic, but they're always looking for extra work, extra good deeds, extra rewards, extra ways they can worship Allah and please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And for them is the higher status with Allah. يؤمنون بالله واليوم الآخر ويأمرون بالمعروف وينهون عن المنكر ويسارعون في الخيرات أولئك من الصالحين. Allah says what means they are the ones who believe in Allah and they believe in the last day and they enjoin the ma'roof, Tawheed first and foremost, and obeying and following the Quran and the Sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they forbid the munkar, shirk and kufr, disbelief and polytheism, and opposing the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they hasten, they always hurry to do good deeds and good works. They are amongst the righteous ones. None of us will go to Jannah without the mercy of Allah, not our deeds. Our deeds will not get us into Jannah, it is the rahmah of Allah. But our deeds will help us earn that mercy. And when, if we go to Jannah, those deeds will raise us in levels and rank till we're high up near the Arsh of Ar-Rahman, near the throne of the Most Merciful. On the authority of Abu Huraira, he narrated that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَمَا تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ عَبْدِي بِشَيْءٍ أَحَبَّ إِلَيَّ مِمَّا افْتَرَدْتُهُ عَلَيْهِ وَلَا يَزَالُ عَبْدِي يَتَقَرَّبُ إِلَيَّ بِالنَّوَافِلْ حَتَّى أُحِبَّهُ فَإِذَا أَحْبَبْتُهُ كُنْتُ سَمْعُهُ الَّذِي يَسْمَعُ بِهِ وَبَصَرُهُ الَّذِي يُبْصِرُ بِهِ وَيَدَهُ الَّتِي يَبْطِشُ بِهَا ورجله التي يمشي بها ولئن سألني لأعطينه ولئن استعاذني لأعيذنه رواه البخاري. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he narrated this hadith Qudsi, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, whoever shows enmity to a friend of mine, then I have declared war against him. When my servant does and my servant does not draw closer to me or nearer to me with anything more love to me than the religious duties I made obligatory upon them. Yani the five daily prayers, the zakat al-mal, the fasting of Ramadan, hajj once in your lifetime, etc. And my servant will continue to draw closer to me and closer to me until hatta uhibba, until I love him. And when I love him, I'm the hearing with which he hears, the sight with which he sees, the hand with which he strikes, the legs with which he walks. And if he asks me for anything, I will give it to him. And if he seeks refuge with me, I will surely grant him or her refuge. In this hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari. So again, we see two ranks from those ibad who do the basic deeds, the minimum, what is obligatory, that Allah, you are drawing near to Allah, no doubt with that. But then there are those who draw near to Allah, hatta uhibba, until Allah loves you. Until Allah loves you. You can be in that rank, near His arsh, by doing those nawafil and doing those extra deeds. So this is the difference between the ranks. So ask yourselves, my brothers in Islam, are you ready to die and meet your Creator? Do you communicate with Allah? Have you performed your daily prayers, paid your zakat, given in sadaqah? Do you earn the pleasure of Allah? Did you do deeds that will earn you Allah's love? Not just the basics, not just the minimum. How did you treat your parents, your family members? Do you maintain the family ties? Did you give in charity to help in Allah's cause? How many times do you remember Allah in the day? Our day is filled with iPads, telephones, all these apps, surfing the web. Our days are filled with work and school. Our days are filled with TV and YouTube and the likes of these matters. How many times did you say Subhanallah? How many times did you say Alhamdulillah? How many times did you say Allahu Akbar? How many times did you say Astaghfirullah? وَكَانَ الرَّسُولُ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ يَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ فِي الْيَوْمِ مِئَةَ مَرَّةٍ. The Prophet ﷺ used to say Astaghfirullah in the day 100 times. So ask yourself and question yourself, what if you lost your life today? How would you meet Allah? What were your potential final actions that you would die upon and take with you to your grave? Because nowadays, life isn't guaranteed. It never was. But it's even more real. Young or old, healthy or sick, COVID, no COVID. When your time comes, it comes, as we've repeated the last couple of weeks. May Allah make us of those who are foremost to do good deeds, not settling for just being basic and minimum. Foremost to do good deeds and always looking to do good deeds in His cause. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ادعوا الله يغفر لكم ذنوبكم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونصلي ونسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد, Alhamdulillah, these raindrops, for your information, some of the companions, they used to go out when it was raining and let it wet their heads. Some of them would take their pillows out because the rain is a barakah, alhamdulillah, and we ask Allah to bless us always. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, وَأَنْفِقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ يَأْتِيَ أَحَدَكُمُ الْمَوْتِ فَيَقُولُ رَبِّي لَوْلَا أَخَّرْتَنِي إِلَىٰ أَجْلٍ قَرِيبٍ فَأَصَّدَّقَ وَأَكُمْ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says what means, and spend in charity what we have provided for you. Spend in charity. This is above, going above what's required of you, be above the obligation. From what we have provided for you, everything we own, even if it's on your bank account in your name, it belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Before death comes to you, as we've said in the last few weeks, it can come at any time. And then one of you will say, my Lord, if only you give me respite, if only you send me back to the earth, if only you give me one more day on the earth, I will give in charity at that time, I promise you. It will. This is what you will say, and be amongst the righteous. But we will not be granted that. There is no life in this dunya once we've left this dunya. So give in the cause of Allah. Abu Huraira, he narrated a person came to the Prophet ﷺ and said, أَيُّ صَدَقَ أَفْضَلْ. What charity is the best? فَقَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ أَن تَصَدَّقَ وَأَنْتَ صَحِيحٌ شَحِيحٌ تَخْشَى الْفَقَرِ وَتَأْمُلُ الْغِنَى وَلَا تُمْهِلْ حَتَّى إِذَا بَلَغَتِ الْحُلْقُومِ قُلْتُ لِفُلَانٍ كَذَا وَلِفُلَانٍ كَذَا أَلَا وَقَدْ كَانَ لِفُلَانٍ. رواه مسلم. When the Prophet ﷺ was asked what charity is best, he said that you give charity when you're in a state of health, you're not on your deathbed, that you give charity when you're closed-fisted, fearing poverty. And this has been a year where many of us have feared how we may get our rent, how we may get our food, how we may get what we may need, medicine, even for that fact. This is the best time that you give in charity, when you're healthy, closed-fisted, fearing poverty, and hoping to become rich. Charity in such a state of health and mind is best. And you must not defer or delay your charity till that time comes when you're on your deathbed and you say, give such and such to this person, give so much to this person, because it has already been written for them. Because Allah knew what you were going to do at that time. Our Prophet ﷺ, he said, ذِلُّ الْمُؤْمِنِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ صَدَقَةً. The shade for the believer on the day of resurrection, the day of fear, the day which is 50,000 years long, is his or her charity that they give in the cause of Allah. My brothers in Islam, we've heard about the benefits of charity. The ayat in the Quran are full of them. We just heard you can be three types of ibad. The one who wrongs himself, the one who does the basics, or the one who's always going above and beyond, going extra, the extra mile to do extra good deeds.